The crusade he launched next would prove so controversial that not even his new wife would be spared the blowback. Some historians, including all-American mafioso author Charles Rapallai, maintain that Billy Wilkerson ignited his communist witch hunt as a smokescreen, a way to cover up his involvement with organized crime. Certainly, by 1946, he had more to hide on that count than ever. But a more likely explanation is that he was returning to his long-term objective, to get revenge on the studio bosses and destroy their unfair movie monopoly. If he exposed the studio's creative talent as communists in the pages of The Reporter and demanded they be drummed out of the industry, he'd be striking a blow at his enemy's ability to make money. Billy wanted to clobber the studio owners, Joe Pasternak explained. Convenient targets, such as their writers, just happened to be in the way. And if his campaign, the first of its kind, proved successful, he'd raise his own profile and that of his paper, proving once and for all who really held the reins of power in the film capital. Wilkerson's chosen target demonstrates once again his remarkable sense for what scandals would capture the attention of the public. In post-war America, fear and hatred of communism were on the rise. Communist Russia's brutal dictator, Joseph Stalin, had ended World War II by gobbling up the nations of Eastern Europe and bringing some 100 million more people into the oppressive grip of the Soviet Union. At home, Stalin initiated purges of his political enemies and butchered his own people. The horror that Americans felt over communism's rise is not unlike the fear that gripped later generations at the rise of ISIS. And Wilkerson had no compunction about appealing to people's growing anxiety in order to sell newspapers.